We're going to discuss about various diabetes medications, i.e. medications that are used to control blood sugar levels in people who do have diabetes mellitus, otherwise called as elevated blood sugar, and their effect on body weight. This is very important because obesity in itself is one of the key predisposing risk factor for a person to develop what we call as type 2 diabetes or adult onset diabetes mellitus. Also, if a person were to be obese, other than increasing the risk of high blood sugar levels, it also predisposes the individual to many other health ailments, such as that can restrict a person's physical activity by causing excessive burden on one's knees. It can also result in higher cholesterol levels. It can also result in sleep apnea, what is otherwise easily known in most people as snoring during nighttime during sleep. It can also result in liver problems, fatty liver. It can also result in heart attacks, brain strokes, so on and so forth. It can even lead to cancer. So it is important to make sure that people with diabetes do not become overweight so that they don't overburden themselves with the burden of excessive weight, which restricts their physical activity and also putting themselves to risk of all other health ailments that we have discussed so far. In this context, it is pertinent to discuss about the various medications that are used to control blood glucose levels in people with diabetes and how they affect the blood glucose levels as well as affect their body weight. To begin with, we'll start with metformin. Metformin is a very commonly used medication in type 2 diabetics. In fact, it is one of the first line medication to be used in any individual who has developed diabetes unless there is a contraindication. This medication is weight neutral. It does not cause significant amount of weight loss, but at the same time it does not cause weight gain on its own in a person who has diabetes when it is used. Next comes a separate group of medications called sulfonylureas. These have been in the market for a few decades. They are time tested, but unfortunately they do cause weight gain. So it is important to try to avoid these medications in people who are already overweight. The other group of medications that next come in line are something called thiazolidinediones, also called TZDs, and the example for it is something called pioglitazone. This is still available in the market. It is a good medication in itself and used judiciously, but unfortunately it causes water retention and hence weight gain in people who have diabetes when it is used to control blood sugar levels. Next comes another group of medications called alpha glucosidase inhibitors, example for which are commonly used medications such as acarbose and oglibose. These are weight neutral. They do cause some decrement in blood sugar levels, but they don't cause any increment in body weight. Next comes a group of medications called DPP-4 inhibitors. These are something which have been available in the market for about a decade or so. And these group of medications do not cause weight gain. They do not cause weight loss, and they're supposed to be weight neutral when they're used to control blood sugar levels. Then comes a recent group of medications which have been in the market for about 3 years or so. They're called SGLT2 inhibitors. These tablets, when used for controlling blood sugar levels, can in fact cause weight loss and have significant beneficial effect in people who do have type 2 diabetes mellitus, because losing weight can be a challenge in these individuals otherwise. Then comes insulin, which is the most commonly used medication once your oral medications fail. Insulin, whilst being a wonderful medication in its ability to control blood sugar levels, despite this extremely beautiful and physiological benefit of insulin, it does have a side effect in the form of its ability to cause weight gain when it is used in people with diabetes mellitus. So we ought to be a bit extra cautious when we are using insulin in people who do have diabetes, as it can cause a bit of weight gain. Last but not the least, we do have another newer group of medications which have been in the market for about 15 years or so. These are called GLP-1 receptor agonists. These are usually given in the form of injections once a day, twice a day, or sometimes even once weekly, and these medications have a beautiful benefit, an excellent extra benefit in their ability to cause weight loss apart from their ability to control blood sugar levels. So, ladies and gentlemen, so far we have been able to discuss about various groups of medications that are used to control blood sugar levels in diabetes, and at the same time, their beneficial effect on weight loss or weight neutrality or the side effect of weight gain in certain individuals. So, I think it is important to discuss with your doctor whilst you are discussing your health ailments, apart from your obesity, apart from your cholesterol, blood pressure, blood cholesterol, fat, etc., that you discuss the effect of these medications on your bodily weight, so that you can in fact benefit from the beneficial effects of some of the newer groups of medications if possible. Thank you. So, dear viewers, if you want to learn more about health related issues and solutions for such issues, please do subscribe to Health Masters YouTube channel.